Now I would like to request our most beloved mother, Ama Chinzu Pemela, to give a few words of blessing.
The Honourable Minister, Government of India, for Culture and for and the Vice Chancellor of the University, Kishing Aung Samdela, Vice Chancellor of the Tibetan Institute for Higher Education, and fellow recipients of the degree, honorary degree, then the faculty and students of the Institute, and ladies and gentlemen, I am very humbled to receive this honorary degree for on behalf of the work that we have done for the Tibetan children. As you are well aware, ever since His Holiness came into exile, one of the first things that he felt that he must do is to give our children a good education. He always refers to the Tibetan children as the future seeds of Tibet, and to nurture this seed so that they bear good fruit, His Holiness emphasized that the education that we give to our children must be an education which is modern, but at the same time, an education which is deeply rooted in our own culture, in our religion, in our identity as Tibetans. And towards this end, the Tibetan children's villages have worked, and we have just recently celebrated the 58th anniversary of the existence of the children's village. And over these years, over 52,000 children have passed out from our children's villages, and they form part of the Tibetan community. And over 52,000 children means one third of the Tibetan population in exile. So we are really very proud that we have been able to do this, and this has been due only thanks to the generosity of the Indian government and many voluntary agencies and individuals from all over the world. We could not have been able to do all this had it not been for the help and the generosity. And we are always grateful for all that we have received while we have been in exile. And today, here in the Institute, I am happy to be here because I have found many of our students from the Tibetan Children's Village studying here, those who have passed out from this Institute, who are working in the Institute. And in the last 50 years of this Institute's existence, it has played a very important role in the lives of the Tibetan youth and also in preserving our Tibetan rich cultural heritage. And this culture, His Holiness always says that it must be preserved because it is of great value, not only to the Tibetans, but also for anybody across the world who come, you know, close to it and to know. Because this is a culture which teaches us about our inner values, how to be more kind, how to be more compassionate, how to make the world a more peaceful and harmonious world. And this is a culture which, for the Tibetans, we have received from India through the teachings of Lord Buddha and his followers. And this is a teaching that we have preserved in India. In Tibet, we have translated the text into Tibetan. And today, the Tibetan language has fortunately saved all these teachings of Lord Buddha, the teachings from Nalanda University. And it is also the wish of His Holiness that someday these teachings from Tibetan could be translated into Sanskrit or into many world languages, so that it can be a benefit for the whole world. And I, over the 50 years of this institution's existence, it has contributed very much to to whatever work they're doing and for the culture. And today, as Keshing Awa Samdela, the Vice Chancellor, has expressed in his speech, there are many activities going on in this institution. And whatever good work one does, it always takes time and a lot of people's energy and the generosity of the government of India and also many individuals across the world. And so I take this opportunity to wish this, the Chancellor and the Vice Chancellor and all the faculty members that they continue with this work so that we can all be proud of it, that our young people can benefit. And then good luck and, may you get all the blessings so that the work will flourish as well as ever. Thank you.